Diane Daniel here, and I wanted to say thank you to ZenMaid for inviting me to be a part of the Maid Service Success Summit 2020. It has been quite a year. And today I'm going to talk about what's love got to do with cleaning. Remember that Tina Turner song? What's love got to do with it? I'm a terrible singer. So I wanted to tell you about what's love got to do with cleaning today. And it has a whole lot to do with it, because love is the one thing that all humans are looking for and need. And why am I talking about this in regards to a cleaning company? And the reason is, there was a study that was put out, Gallup put out a study a few years back, and it said that 67% of employees are actively disengaged. So think about that number, 67%. So if you're thinking about it in the terms of your own company, and 67% of your employees may be actively disengaged, that presents a problem, right? Because you need your employees engaged for the success of your company. When you set up a company, you have systems in place, you have your financials, you have the products that you use, and then you have the team members that you invite to be a part of your team for your company's success. And so that's where love comes into play. So a few years back, my husband and I did a book study of the 5 love languages with Gary Chapman, and I'm quite sure many of you are familiar with that, and you may already know what your love language is, and that's fantastic. So we learned about our love languages and how we communicate with others and how we receive communication. So we decided to use that in our home and with our children, and then we read another book, which was The 5 Love Languages of Appreciation in the Workplace, also by Gary Chapman, and this time it was co-written by Paul White. So we read the book and we decided to implement that into our company, because our primary motto in our company is to lead in love. And so this was right in alignment with it. And so we started doing the love language assessment actually during that initial packet when a team member is coming on board. And so not only do we do their, you know, the legal documents that we have to have on file and everything, but we also do a love language assessment, which is like a question little quiz that they do. We don't ask them for the answers. We just ask them that they tell us their top 3 love languages. And so the 5 love languages, if you're not familiar with them, I'm just going to go over them real quick, are words of affirmation, quality time, receiving gifts, acts of service, and physical touch. So those are the 5 love languages, and we're each wired higher on some of them than others. And so what it does with that assessment is we're able to see how they're wired. So for example, if someone is wired in words of affirmation and physical touch, when that trainee goes out into the field to train with our trainer knows that those are the 2 primary love languages for that new team member. And so what they're able to do is, if the team member is doing something well, they can affirm them and say, hey, you did a great job on that. But they also know that since that team member's words of affirmation, they want, if they need to correct them, that they want to be able to say, hey, you know, I see that you're putting a lot of effort in, you know, we need to make this correction, and then, you know, and then check the outcome. And then, you know, we can take it from there. But you always want to be mindful depending on what their love language is. So words of affirmation, you want to give them a compliment, then make the correction, and then possibly close out with a compliment also. If they're physical touch, a high five, a fist pump, you know, those are ways that you could say, oh, you did fantastic, you know, and give them a fist pump. Or yeah, a high five. So those are ways to communicate. It might sound a little quirky or a little corny, but it works. Trust me. If you are communicating with someone, and I know we've all had those interactions where someone is just not getting what we're saying. For example, if someone speaks to you in a different language and you don't know how to speak that language, you can't receive the compliment, even though they gave it to you, because you're not speaking the same language. And so that's how it is with the love languages, the five love languages. That little nugget, that little piece, that helps with your employee engagement. If someone feels valued and appreciated, if you're speaking to them in their love language, then they are going to be more engaged, because they're going to feel like, okay, I matter. Someone really cares about me. And you do want to care about your team, right? If you're inviting someone to be a part of a reflection of your company, you want to be able to sow into them. And the thing with the what's love got to do with cleaning is that you really need to love your team. And you need to know how to communicate with your team, because they're going out there and they're serving the community. And I mean, now more than ever, we need cleaning, right? Can you imagine a world without cleaning? It would be a disaster. The job that we do, the work that we do is very important. And the team that we select is very important, and how we treat them and how we communicate with them. And the employee engagement is one of the biggest factors of success in business. So why not make the investment? The love languages is just a little nugget. You know, it's something that we love to do, and we get to learn a little bit about each other. And the trainers and the trainees, they know, everyone knows each other's love language. And so it allows us to communicate in that way and make a conscious decision. Like, another love language is receiving gifts. That's not my primary love language, but I know that if I have a team member and their love language is receiving gifts, I go out of my way to make sure that we're communicating to each person in the way that they receive it. So even though I'm not wired that way, I can be more conscious in my decision making and how I'm communicating with my team. And so that in turn makes for better employee engagement. So there's some other stuff too that we do that we love to love on our team. So recently we did wellness week, right? And so we sent the team to go and have like a foot detox and a foot massage. The team's on their feet all day. They work hard. And so we want to be able to make sure that we show appreciation. During all of this time, we added benefits. We didn't have benefits in the past, right? So over the past 3 or 4 months, we said, no, we want to add dental, we want to add medical, and we did those things. We want to be sure that the things that we're providing for our team are of value to them, and it creates employee engagement. Another piece to that, in addition to adding the benefits, doing the love language assessment, sending them to, you know, have a little pamper time, is, you know, our team meetings were a little bit different because we had stipulations. We couldn't meet, now with the whole COVID-19, we couldn't meet in the regular conference room setting. So we set up a team meeting, outdoor seating at Panera, and we did a breakfast meeting. You know, so those are all things that we have done because love has a whole lot to do with cleaning. So when you ask the question, what's love got to do with cleaning? It has a whole lot. Love on your team. You have the systems in place. You have the financials. You have, you know, the products you're using. You have your clients that you're retaining. But just be sure to love on your team. Sometimes, you know, you think about it or you overthink it. Sometimes it's the simplest little things. Knowing how your team is wired in their love language, going, you know, above and beyond for them, it doesn't necessarily have to cost you an arm and a leg. And that's the whole thing, that sometimes we get caught up on costs and running things. And let's not forget the piece of the employee engagement and really having a team that enjoys what they do, they feel valued in the workplace, and a team that can grow with you. Because your company's success depends on the team that you select and that you have during the time that you're building your company. So with that being said, when the question is asked, what's love got to do with cleaning? The answer is everything. Love has got to everything to do with cleaning. And on that note, I just wanted to say, enjoy what you do. Enjoy the journey. Enjoy the process. I know some days it's hard, when you're working with your team, but if you implement a few different things, it just may make it a little bit easier. And when you know that you have a team that you could truly love on, and you know, use the love language assessment, use those little pieces in those tools that you have available to you. You know, with all of the employee disengagement that you have in some companies, 67%, and only 25% of companies actually have a strategic plan for their employee engagement, you know, that doesn't have to be you. You can have a plan in place that will assist your team in growing, and everyone can actually be better humans. Isn't that awesome? You know, if you could learn the love languages, implement it in the workplace, and it spills over and you can actually communicate better with your family and out in the world, it's a win-win for everyone. So what's love got to do with cleaning? It has everything to do with cleaning. Call me if you need anything. I'm here for you. I'd love to talk to you about the love languages and how it's affected us and our team. Once again, Diane Daniel with Enjoy Life Cleaning Services, and I'll see you soon.